Check, check, mic check.
Snow, we're doing our fishing today, maybe do a little singing in Farmer. You know, say that I'm a snow, me, I go blam, con, comma. That's what we're doing, we're going fishing.
Dad?
Yeah?
Oh my God.
That is huge. That is huge, first of all.
That Hunting Girl with Amanda Lynn Mihu is proudly brought to you by CF Moto, Bell Outdoors, the Canadian Coalition for Firearm Rights, NITO Canada, Greenstone Tourism, Impact Baits, Jiffy Ice Drills, Larry Hudson Chevrolet, Fatal Attraction Outdoors, Tough Duck, TS Custom Calls, and by Core Lane Sporting Goods. To you a little bit about why I do what I do, where it came from, and how it's grown into what it has. I was born and raised hunting and fishing with my dad and my mom, my sister. Growing up in a very remote town in Northern Ontario, this is just what we did. It was a no-brainer. I mean, people were always out gathering and harvesting food and having fun and making memories with their families and their children, and it was a part of my life.
Hi, my name is Cash. I'm 11 years old, and I'm fishing with Amanda Lynn Mihu.
To know the importance of conservation and where your food comes from and having those bonding family moments is what makes life, life. Raising my children the same way, to spend all of those moments with them in the outdoors, teaching them how to drive, teaching them how to harvest their first birds, sitting in the tree stands with them, watching them be successful in their hunts, watching them, you know, just grow up with each other and hang out with me and learn the importance again of conservation and where your food comes from and how to properly use tools like trucks and off-road machines and firearms and archery equipment. It is all quite important. And I raised three boys who all have their own families now, and they all have incredible qualities that I am proud to say that has come from the way that they were raised. They appreciate the world and life around them. They appreciate animals. They appreciate who they're with, and they respect people, and they respect how they were raised. And I'm very, very proud of each and every one of them. And having them being grown up and out of the house and having their own families and stuff, I mean, I spent 20 years as a 24/7 mom, and you know, that was what I did, and that was my full-time job. Anything and everything to keep them safe, to protect them and give them the best that I could. And I wasn't always at ease with life. For this particular hunt, we will be using a combination of mouth calls and pot calls. The good thing about mouth calls is that you are hands-free, so you can get the job done without getting busted by the turkeys. You know, being in situations that you can't control financially, I've been there, medical complications, I've been there, I'm still struggling with that, and being a single mom. So being able to overcome all of those things and be where I am today, and taking time and talking to people who want to talk to me and ask me questions, and the kids that want to come up and ask me questions, and, you know, them telling me that when they grow up, they want to be just like me, and it's overwhelming. It's exciting. I'm very honored. I'm very flattered. But it, having my children having their own lives now allows me to spend more time with others and doing a lot of the things that I'm doing now, including shooting all the shows and all the outreach programs. And I want to get more involved with outreach programs when it comes to children. I love showcasing the adventures on Just Hunt. I think that it's important to showcase not only just an entertaining episode or an episode that always has a story, and every single my episodes has a story, but to show how, when given an opportunity like this, which I never thought that I would ever have, and helping inspire others and giving them maybe a pathway, or giving them inspiration to get outdoors and just, I don't know, do what I do and have fun with it and get more people outdoors. And there's nothing that compares to being outdoors. There's nothing.
This is the last day of the moose hunt here in Geraldton, Long Lac area. I'm out with Joe and Chris. We've been scouting since the sun came up this morning for fresh tracks. So we have a little bit of a game plan in store, but we're going to...
And it doesn't matter how cold it is, and it doesn't matter how windy it is. It doesn't matter if it's raining sideways. There are a ton of companies out there that make a ton of gear in order for you to be as protected as possible to enjoy the outdoors in any kind of element whatsoever. The last part of my year was filmed between minus 32 and minus 44, and I was very well dressed for it. It was a little uncomfortable at times, especially if you had to use the washroom.
So we just showed up at a really good spot that Joe kind of scouted out earlier, and there's lots of fresh tracks and some hair on the ground.
I was a little bit concerned because I have asthma, and sometimes when you're in Northern Ontario in those kind of very frigid temperatures, it almost like the air kind of sucks the oxygen right out of your lungs. And I had a really kind of a cool mask that was like a hard neoprene on the outside, so I looked like Star Wars, one of the troopers from Star Wars. And then it just kind of wraps around your head, and you know what? That made my comfort level straight up. It was amazing to have that. And I could even wear it under my snowmobile helmet, so that was pretty perfect too. The whole year this year, my whole entire season, starting back in January of 2019, would take me ice fishing. I came up with the idea because following Take Me Hunting in Range Days, I had quite a few messages from girls who, you know, they wanted to go on an adventure, and they wanted to learn more and be more confident in the outdoors, but they hadn't gone through and gotten their firearms and their hunting licenses yet, so they couldn't really do that. And in the summertime, it's a little bit harder for people to get together to do kind of like a take me fishing, which I have done in the past, but schedules get really crazy. However, in January and February, there's not a whole lot going on. There's predator hunting, and I have a couple of trade shows, so it was quite easy to organize and put together a take me ice fishing, and you really don't need much. So together with Mitchell's Fish Huts over at Lake Simcoe, we made a beautiful weekend with four girls who I had never met before, and staying overnight in a cabin.
Perfect. This beats my mom.
It was amazing. It was amazing. I mean, we're friends for life now, and the girls are friends with each other, and they've had other adventures together and stuff too. And we had lots of fun, and we caught some fish. Incredible year. I did my spring bear hunt in New Brunswick and also did the Miramichi Striper Cup for the very first time, and I can't wait to go back this year. I did, I went to Alberta and I did an elk hunt, and I did some duck hunting while I was there, and I went, where else did I go? I went to BC. I did some traveling around BC, got to see the sights and, you know, tried to do a little bit of a hunt, but it didn't turn out very well. But it was just beautiful being in BC. And the fact that I was in BC and didn't even know that I was in the exact same area where my grandfather lived and hunted way back in the 80s in the Williams Lake area in BC was pretty incredible. And I didn't even plan it that way. It's just kind of how it worked out. I traveled to Northern Ontario and did the fall bear hunt, which of course is something that I've done my whole life, but I ended up going towards the Timmins Foliate area with Melissa and Aaron Plouffe and Junior Ambassador Wade. And I sat with Wade in the tree stand for a couple of days, and we had a little bit of action, but I think Craig stole all the action that week, so. But that's okay. That's okay because it's still meat in my freezer. Where else did I go this year? I went to, the end of the year in December, traveling by myself all the way up and doing the Northern Ontario tour was a phenomenal feeling, and it might have been a little too overwhelming for me. I started here in West Grey at my home, traveled Highway 11 all the way up through North Bay, New Liskeard, Inglehart, past Kirkland Lake, Matheson, where I used to live and go to school, up through past Cochrane and Iroquois Falls, where I went to high school, and through Smooth Rock Falls into Kapuskasing, Long Lac, did some moose hunting there, and that was cold, let me tell you. Traveling after, I think I was there for about 4 or 5 days, ended the moose hunting season, which ended December 15th, and traveled west to Nipigon and met up with Jenny in Nipigon, and that was quite chilly as well. We had an exciting time wolf hunting, and we had some very weird things that happened that week.
I'm Hannah.
And then coming back around, through Scriber, where my uncle used to live, and had a pretty incredible chat with some residents of Scriber when I had stopped to get some gas, and they recognized my grandfather's name and my uncle, and it's always very heartfelt when you run into somebody that knows a part of your family and where you come from, and it kind of helps it all make sense as to what you're doing. And then pulling into Manitowoc. I love pulling into Manitowoc. I love being a part of Manitowoc. It is my hometown. It is where I was raised, and it helped form the person that I am today. The people that I grew up with, the hobbies and activities that I was involved in, and hardships and friendships that I went through in Manitowoc. You all pushed me to be this person today. Leaving Manitowoc and heading to Sault Ste. Marie, spending a couple of minutes with my sister because she's so busy, and getting to hang out with a couple of old friends just kind of overnight, and finally hooking up with my elk meat, which has been a task in itself. If you're ever going to go out of province to do any sort of hunting, please make sure that you figure out how you're gonna get your wild game home before you actually participate or spend money on your travels, because I had one heck of a time trying to get that wild game home for sure. finally got that home and made it all the way back home 2 days before Christmas. I might have done some Christmas shopping along the way and kind of had 2 days to whip it all together and put on a Christmas dinner on December 25th with half of my children and December 26th with the other half of my children. And so it ended up being an incredibly full year with back-to-back hunting and outreach programs.
We are starting Take Me Hunting Deer Day 2 with a waterfowl goose hunt. Dave's got some decoys out in the field. He's gonna do some calling, and hopefully the girls will get shooting.
The shotgun only holds two casings, right?
Three.
Three?
Yes.
Oh, and then the one goes in there.
That's right. So okay. Do you have one in the chamber?
No, I don't have one in the chamber.
Okay, so pump one into the chamber. So
okay.
Pull.
Okay, well, I'm on.
Put your,
I'm hot right now.
Oh, well, put your safety on. Push down on that. We did 6 range days across Ontario. I did 3 take me hunting, 1 take me ice fishing, and 1 take me off-roading this year, along with my very own adventures with my husband and by myself and with other friends involved. Has been an incredibly action-packed full year, and I can't wait to do it again. One more thing I want to add. I just don't know how to word it. Okay. Do-it-yourself hunts have always been, well, I mean, it was all I knew, really. I didn't know there was things out there like outfitters and guides and et cetera. I figured if you wanted to harvest an animal, you just get out there and you do it yourself and you figure it out. And for the most part, I had my dad's guidance. I had guidance from friends like Ray Obey from Manitowoc and my uncles, Uncle Fred in Kenora area, Uncle Jurgen, who is no longer with us now, and a couple of other friends. You know, you learn as much as you can and you take in as much as you can by being in the experiences and getting out there and doing it. And with the guidance of those people and taking in, oh, and the guidance of my husband too. I guess when it comes to deer hunting, because I had never been a deer hunter until I met Craig, but moose, bear, and you know, grouse and stuff, yeah, always, like since I was little. But you learn to know what you know, if that makes any sense. And for me, do-it-yourself hunting, I think it's, I don't know, it's something that's in my blood, and it's something that I have such a hard time passing that off to someone else. So I have been with an outfitter, I'm gonna say twice. The pheasant hunt was a game farm, and that was a couple years ago, and going to Newfoundland and doing the moose hunt was with an outfitter, and I did have a guide with me, but the guide also allowed me to be me, so he had to be with me, but he didn't kind of overstep or like, he didn't really, I don't know how to say it, but he didn't take over. Like, he let me be the hunter. And in the spring bear hunt this year, I did go with Brian Williams, who does have his own outfitting company. But again, he was with me, but he still let me be me. I've never been in a position where, I've never been in a position where someone told me, you're gonna get that animal 100% ever. And I've never had that expectation with anything that I've ever hunted. Do-it-yourself hunting, I think you learn a lot more and you respect the hunt a lot more. You have more, I don't know, like, it's up to you. It's up to you to do it yourself. And you're not relying on someone else to get it for you. And I think that just means a whole lot more. And to be able to help inspire others or mentor others in their own do-it-yourself hunts is a great feeling. And I like to eat. I love meat. I like to eat, and for that reason alone is the reason I hunt. That Hunting Girl with Amanda Lynn Mayhew is proudly brought to you by CF Moto, Bell Outdoors, the Canadian Coalition for Firearm Rights, NITO Canada, Greenstone Tourism, Impact Baits, Jiffy Ice Drills, Larry Hudson Chevrolet, Fatal Attraction Outdoors, Tough Duck, TS Custom Calls, and by Core Lane Sporting Goods.